Cam Lewis to boot it away. And Britton Covey, the electric diminutive returner, is deep for the Utes. And he'll bring it. Covey, who returned a punt against the Ducks in round one, stays alive. Man, is he a dangerous returner. Gives the Utes pretty good field position out near the 40. And they fight and push the pile. I think it's going to be a first down when the dust settles.
Wow.
It is.
Wow.
They choose not to buzz it down. And now in a first down throw, a slant is complete. Catch made by Solomon Enos, and the Utes are threatening. Ryzen looking to throw again on first down. Flips it underneath, and the catch is made by Britton Covey, who cuts it back. Covey knifing down to the 15-yard line. A sharp start for this Utah. Play clock winding down. Rising launches a fade to the end zone, and it's incomplete, but a flag. Jalen Dixon was covered by Mikhail Wright.
Right away, the fact that you don't see Wright turn for the football is what usually is going to get the initial recognition from the official. Never found the football.
He's got the football, and he walks in. And the Utes razor sharp for the opening possession. They get 61 yards. Could not have drawn it up any better than that. Nice run-pass mix.
Absolutely. And left side of this offensive line with a good push here. Watch him just read this. It's designed to go to the right.
Brown on the move. And the ankle is hampered. Didn't appear to be much of a factor. Utes rush four. Brown straight back. And it's picked off. It's Lloyd headed for the end zone. Pick six. Devin Lloyd. Finalist and first round pick, captain, leader of this team, Kirk, makes a huge play.
Well, he probably studies as much film as any linebacker.
Four man rush, ball out quickly, catch made by Hudson. He makes a move, dives. He does have first down yardage with a flag down.
Pass interference, offense number 10.
Protection breaking down, and they've got him at the five. The Utes are swarming. The back in motion, and as he's looking to the right, slant again. Catch made by one of those tight ends, Dalton Kincaid, the junior from right here in Las Vegas. Rising, another quick throw, and that one is intercepted. Threw it right into the hands of Noah Sewell, and that's the kind of play Oregon needed to provide a spark. In this matchup of Sewell brothers, it's Noah who makes the first big play.
Chris, you're going to love this. We just talked about how they're attacking the interior of this defense. Watch Sewell initially look here and then come off and pick up the second route. Watch his eyes. He looks inside, comes off, and then jumps that throw.
Second and four. Brown keeps it, now throws it. McGee in the flat as a first down and accelerates that inside the Utah 30. Nice little play. Utes don't bring pressure. Brown does have time, fires downfield, but way over the head of Troy Franklin. No chance to make a play that time. And a guy who missed a couple against the Utes in Salt Lake City would stall the momentum. Micah Bernard is the back. Rising, throws a nice little dart, and it's complete for a first down. Third down again, they need three. Rising keeping it, and again, able to navigate to a first down in midfield. Keeper again. Rising, stiff arm. Loses the football, scramble on the sidelines. He goes out of bounds, and Utah's going to maintain possession. Sewell is in on the play. Looking to throw again and first down. Hit as he throws the ball, goes straight up in the air, and a diving interception. It was all about the quarterback pressure, but Barone McKinley III, sixth pick of the year to take over the lead. Christian Williams just leveled him.
Wow. Great job, 91, getting around the center forward. And you're right. I mean, it's a heck of a job of recognizing the balls in the air by McKinley. Third down.
Brown has has time across the middle. Dive, not going to get near the marker. Devin Lloyd was in the area patrolling. Second and 11, rising a slant. And the catch is made by Grant Keithy. First one tonight for the top receiver. And third and 3, Thomas cuts it back and spins for a first down. Thomas makes a cut. Now, if you watch the first game, you know this is where Utah completely blew it open late in the first half with a drive to go up 21-0. Rising on third and long, right down the middle. Is Dalton Kincaid. Rising with pressure, closing in, delivers a strike across the middle. Dalton Kincaid and the tight ends dominant on that drive as the Utes stretch it to a 3-touchdown lead. So reminiscent of the first matchup. It's a high snap. Now they're trying to scramble, and Mike Williams, the punter and the holder, plays downfield. They've been really hard to come by. Tafua chasing Brown. They close in on him. He gets around the corner and just flings it and is picked off. So a disastrous decision. Thought he was just going to throw it away or keep it. And Mataele makes an interception, and the Utes have 8 seconds trying to add to this lead. Wow.
What's the, you know, I thought he was just going to step out of bounds, obviously, or just throw it away. Great pressure without blitzing.
Oregon will get the ball to begin the second half. Rising takes a short pass on the outside, so with 5 seconds to go, trying to build the lead here, and Redding drives it right through. So Anthony Brown does pay for that decision. Not, but mentally he has not been his usual self. Dye wasn't much of a factor in the first half, just tripped up by a shoestring tackle. Brown under pressure, back pedals, and delivers just a little late, getting there early and interfering was Cole Bishop, the excellent true freshman safety. 10 yards in his first carry of the third quarter. He's got it again. He's got some space and shows some power driving the legs. Good run down to the 35. Devin Lloyd eventually got him to the ground.
Yeah, good.
Brown gets it out quickly on the edge. This is Dye, gets some blocks. And the Ducks beginning to get some chunk plays, and Dye's been a big part.
Showing pressure and backed out.
And they back it out. Brown has time, delivers downfield at the goal line, knocked away, incomplete. Devin Williams was there, but Cole Bishop, that freshman again, broke it up. Lewis is out of trouble kicking field goals against Utah. Missed his first three. Was 0 for 1 tonight, but knocks it through.
Officials on the field rule it the offense's ball. That's what it is.
Third and 3 is incomplete, so the Ducks do get off the field there. And the snap gets past Brown, who has to dive at the goal line. Was he outside of the end zone? Yes. No safety. They'll spot it a foot away from the goal line.
Two things bad there. The snap and the timing of the jet motion by Hudson. Forsythe snaps this ball.
Third and 22. Brown, feet moving around. And he can't escape. Wrapped at the 5 by Fillinger again. What a series for the freshman from Draper, Utah. Fledger's the back. Fake it to him. Rising on the keep. Slip tackles. Rising in the secondary. Weaving his way all the way down to the 4-yard line. Cam Rising makes an electric play.
Little zone read.
First and goal here now. And Thomas barrels in. The trick. Fledger check it, and a touchdown for Utah. They get the short field, the big run by the quarterback sets up the touchdown run, and there's some tempers after the play. Rising, escapes, and scampers in. And the Utah faithful, they can smell it. The Rose Bowl beckons. They're jumping around on the far side of the field as the Utes again are.
I mean, I was all wound up thinking it's going to be a brawl for 60 minutes, and only one team showed up tonight.
Franklin makes the catch. I agree. It's inexplicable.
A reminder.
Yeah. Third and 1. Dye will worm his way for.
I love hearing a story like that from Holly because.
Fourth down and 4. Ducks got to have it. Brown, a long throw, and it's broken up. Man, that's a long throw to get 4 yards.
like, to me, that's kind of corner you dream about.
Bernard knifing into the secondary. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line. DJ James kind of got run over, but he got him to the ground. And
That's what they talk about, is being a team that's got to – they went to Columbus. Think of that team that went to Columbus.
In motion, Rising took a look, dodged the tackle. They still can't get into the ground. It's another first down in the red zone. And the crowd just appreciating the determination that this team continues to show.
Yeah, Utah.
Thomas again patiently picks his way, lowers his shoulder, and just runs over, folks. It's first and goal. Ending down, and Rising feeds it to him. That was easy. He's walked in twice. And Utah putting a foot in the Ducks. It's a party in Vegas. Look out.
Something really beautiful about one running back and three tight ends.
Dye needs to fight hard. They do convert the third one. Dye converts again and scoots down to the 40.
There's a guy. Always stuck by them.
Here comes the pressure on third and 10. Ball is out and caught. Finally, Williams makes a catch. His first tonight, and he's knocked down at the 22. And a flag comes in, and Tepper's a little flaring on the far side there for the first time. Long throw is caught. Tiptoeing down the sidelines is Crocker, who finally steps out. Dive. Spiting. Reaches the ball across the plane, and it is at a touchdown for Oregon. Finally.
What an effort by Travis Dye, considering how this game has gone and considering we've not seen a lot of it from his teammates. One guy you can count on is 26 to fight. Looked like they had him out, but you can see how he spun.
And Cam Lewis gets the big hop as well executed, but right into the hands of a Ute. And scooting down the sidelines with the return is Solomon Enos. Love, obviously, her son. As Bernard pounds forward here. You know, learning football very late, went to a junior college and
look out.
Oh, the second time in 13 days. It looked exactly what happened in Salt Lake City, but this one's sweeter.
This ball deep to right center field, and it is gone. A two